Well, hello again, everyone. Tonight, on my race to 100 points, throwing washers. Man, I'm going to drink New Riff again. So, I'm doing the single barrel. We're looking at 110.4 proof. Do a lot of barrels, man. They have produced a lot of bourbon. Just getting into Kansas. So, I'm telling you, I'm assuming most people who are watching any of my videos are probably from around here, somewhere close, and I absolutely love it. One of the better bottles of something new I've tried in quite a while, honestly. God, it's just great. So, I might talk about that a little bit more, you know, first half of this. Because at Sam's, we got another case coming in this week, I believe. Didn't move as fast as I thought it would have. I think we went through a case in about 2 weeks. Oh man. Yeah, and it's just delightful. So we'll give you a little dog picture here, see what they're up to. So yeah, please check it out. We've got it at $54.99. I don't know where everybody else is gonna have it, but it's gonna be about it. Should be in that range. And if not, shoot, come up to Sam's. We'll get you hooked up. That's a good doggy's little pet in here. Oh, you're so cute. You're so cute. You know, I got a ball for you. So, yeah, I'm going to go get her ball. So, please check it out. I want to do some comparisons maybe with it. Just what it reminds me of. I'll get to that. I need to refresh on it. Really soak it in a little bit more. Oh, I got a ball. Here we go. Ready? You are not running at all. What are you doing? Let's go. So it rained last night and all these balls were outside. Ready? And so when they spin, there she goes. They fling up a bunch of water and I couldn't zoom in time. So I don't think she likes it as much because she's just getting soaked chasing her balls. So, all right. Oh, she's played a lot. Look, she's not even interested in coming back over here with that. I'm taking my ball, I'm going home. Nope, she's gonna lay in the sun. So, yeah, so I'm telling you, the single barrel, I haven't even tried just the regular bourbon, which I'm gonna have to get a bottle here any minute. But, you know, I try a lot of stuff. I don't get to try a lot of new stuff because I've had so many things. You know, Elijah Tenure was new. But it's not something you can get on the shelf. Like, you have to have in a liquor store around you that's been able to get a barrel of it. So, yeah. So, I wouldn't even compare it that way. I'm just going to give you some views of what I'm looking at as I walk around. That is good. So, I'm considering bottles that I have tried new. You know, I've tried the Trails End eight year. That was a pretty good bottle. You know, I got that Redwood Empire, the Pipe Dream Cast Strength. I've done a few reviews on. That's a good bottle. You know, that's, I would even consider that something you'd be able to get a little bit on the shelf, you know, not very often, but, yeah, so, I'm telling you, check out the New Riff. Talking too much about other stuff. What does it taste like? Mm. It's just wonderful. Let's throw some washers. Sorry. What does it taste like? Oh, that was awful. It's weird when I throw washers, like my brain's never really going. And I'm just kind of zoned out. I don't know. And when I start thinking, even though I'm not even thinking about washers, I'm thinking about what this tastes like what I would compare this to and all that. 4, 5, 6 points there, none in the middle. Oh man, not a good start. But yeah, so yeah, anyway, sorry for how my brain works. Not very entertaining. I don't know if any of this is entertaining anyway, but I just, you know what? It got suggested to me that I should do something like this because I'm out. I mean, even if I'm not recording it, this is kind of what I like to do at night, you know? Like I said, I'm not thinking when I'm doing it. I'm just, the brain's kind of zoned out and, you know, be listening to some music or whatever it may be, you know, some podcasts. So, yeah. You know, let's get back to the bourbon. New Riff, single barrel. It's kind of got a little bit of Elijah Craig flavor. Maybe that's why I enjoy it so much. What else? A little more toasty. If that's actually a word we can use to describe. God dang. I need to throw some in the middle. This is unbelievable. Finally. Oh, nope. There, finally. But it's a little more toasty than Elijah Craig is. Toasty, I guess you could call that barrel. One in, two on. 5 points. Well, this is not how we wanted to start this night off, throwing whiskeys and drinking washers. Sorry. You thought I've already drank tonight, but I actually have not. My first drink of the evening, so goodness sakes. So yeah, I'm getting a little Elijah Craig flavor, you know, it's got some good kick to it. It's, like, it's kind of oak and a little close to chocolate, I guess. I don't know. I don't like. Everybody's taste buds are different. It's impossible to say, hey, this tastes like this, because not everybody's going to taste it the same. But I like doing comparisons because, like, if you say, hey, I like Elijah Craig, well, I'm going to say, hey, you're really going to like this. Where else does this taste? This is gonna be an awful night. I cannot get my distance down, and I don't know why. God, look at that. God, you. I should have started this way quicker. I'm 8 minutes in. I've only shot 3 rounds. And, yeah. I am struggling. Thank God I'm drinking New Riff, because if I was drinking something of less quality, I would not be in a good mood right now, because look at that. Again, none in. 1, 2, 3. What do we got? 2, 4, 6. So we got 6. Count them. So I'm at 12 points down here, 5 points down there. Total of 17 after 3 rounds. Goodness sakes. But yeah, so I'd say Elijah Craig, it's there. So it's a little more toasty. Let's think about this. Like, one name that came to mind that's also kind of hard to get was Henry McKenna Tenure. And, you know, 110 proof on this New Riff single barrel. What else have I had? I mean, it just, It's amazing how it attacks kind of your taste buds. But you still, like I said, that toasty just coating of long-lasting just deliciousness. Yep, my water sure did fall. You could probably caught that. So, I'm telling you, I gotta think of some other things. Dang it. What else? Because I want to be accurate. Or what I consider accurate. Who knows what it actually is. Because, again, your taste buds are different. All right. That was round 4. It's always even numbers going towards the house. So, hopefully, I remember that. 2 in. Hey, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Look at that. That's kick ass. So... What else? Ooh. No, I don't think it's quite that. Let me get a good nose on this real quick, too. Here, let me set you down. That'll get your motion sickness right there. Sorry about that. Ooh. Yep, I got another one for you. Just took a huge nostril of smell out of it. See if something kind of, like, that's how my brain works. So I'll smell it. That's 2 in the middle. And then, like, all of a sudden, something else will pop in my head, you know? Ooh, back to back. Maybe this won't be such a bad night shooting washers. Woo! Look at that. I might be proud of that round. We're going to find out here in a second. But little Knob Creek definitely reminds me of Knob Creek. Look at that. 5 in the middle. That's 15 points. And 4 on the outside. We got 19 there. Hell yeah. Puts me at 31 down here. Beautiful. Beautiful. And I did not move my round number. So, you like Knob Creek? You're going to like that. That's round 5. Where's marking off with a little clip there? Make it easy. Yeah, you like Knob Creek, you'll... This would be up your alley, too. So, definitely better than both of their basic, like the Knob... What's Knob on the shelf? 6? 9 year? I think Knob's 9 year on the shelf. And, you know, your Elijah Craig small batch. This is definitely superior. Well, I like it better than both of those. Let's just put it that way. You're going to be paying more. You know, Elijah, I believe, is 31. Knob, shoot, in the high 20s, I believe, cost-wise. And you're looking at 54 for New Rift, but... Like that, some I kind of overdo. You know, what is going on down there? Is there a lid on that stupid? There, finally. Like you can burn out of stuff. You drink the same thing over and over. It's like, I need to change it up a little bit, you know? Or, and that's what I like to do. Like, my taste buds want different things. I was around 6. They want different things all the time. 1 in, 4 on. That's 7. God dang. I'm only at 22 here. So I'm at 53 after 6 rounds. That's not very good. 20s. What did I say? 27? No. 37. Sorry. Sorry. Yeah. I don't even remember where I was. I was so deep in thought, I literally I moved the marker from here to here and lost track of the score that I had as I moved it. Oh, my God. Anyway, hey, Ryan, why don't you try drinking a little less? But, yeah, so over Elijah Craig. at least for sure they're small batch. I got it above knob 9 year you get on the shelf. I'm gonna go ahead and say it. I like it better than Rare Breed, Wild Turkey Rare Breed, which I absolutely adore. But this is also new to me. You know, this is the first bottle I've been able to get of this. I've got a bottle of Rare Breed up in my bar right now. So, god dang. The shooting is bad. The shooting is bad today. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. We got commotion. God, we'll get one in. One, two, three, four, five. That's 8 points. It gets us to 18 up here, plus 21. We're at 39. So, yeah, I'm telling you, it's delightful. Flavor just keeps coming at you. Like, I'm not quite all the way through. I've got a couple drinks. I take little sips. Just kind of how I do it, I don't know. Like, what I found out is, like, so it's learning, like, right when I started drinking bourbon, like, right when I started getting into it, I ended up being lucky enough to get to go to, on a bourbon trip out to Kentucky. And, I guess it was just one drink. So, I was lucky enough to get to go out there, worked for a distributor, and so we got to see some things that not everybody who gets to go on a tour gets to do. So, I mean, you just learn so much because all the people that went, they're into it, they're asking the right questions. I'm just sitting back, learning, just taking it all in. Get to try so many different things. Just, it was a good experience. Especially, I mean, it couldn't have come at a better time for me in terms of, like, I was just getting into it. That was round 8. Just getting into the bourbons. And so, anyway, 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, and 12. All right, so we're at 13, which is, ooh, that was my second time around. I've lost track of score. I'm pretty sure I have. I'll have to think about it real quick. But yeah, so, like, I got to go to, we went to Buffalo Trace, we went to Maker's, we went to Wild Turkey, Woodford. So we got to go to all these places and I was just soaking it in. I didn't even realize it, you know? Like, as you're doing it, you don't realize how lucky you are. I'm just, like, kind of in just shock and awe. And, I mean, you leave at 9 o'clock in the morning, and at 10:45, you're, you know, trying a bourbon, a really good one. And then it just continues, you know. You might hit 2 distilleries, 3 distilleries a day. So, yeah, I mean, it was a great experience. Helped me try a lot of things. And then when I came back, ooh, let's see what we got. So any leaner like this, basically what I do is I just lift up the side of the board, right? So just pull it off the ground a little bit, make sure the grass isn't holding it on. It's a good shot. So 2 in the middle, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, because that one counts. So, all right, 1, 2, 3, 7. So I was very fortunate that way. And the way I learned to drink bourbon, because I was such a newbie, I hadn't, you know, I was just tasting it. I didn't know how to bring out all the, you know, all the flavors, how to keep that burn down, how to do all those things you need to do to actually get the flavor instead of just getting the bite and the burn off of everything. So I learned that, you know, I learned. Well, they, at least they told me what they, how they said I should do it, you know. They're like, try this, and then you're getting to try it with, that was round 9, sorry. You know, they literally put cheese let you try it. You know, you get a little cheese platter and they're like, okay, drink one without, then try one with a piece of cheese, you know, eat a piece of cheese and then try it. And then, you know, eat a piece of chocolate and try it. Like, those things are real, but it's also kind of the residual flavor you're getting out of it, of the chocolate and the cheese, to enhance what you're drinking. So, like, all that is just, for a guy like me, you just don't appreciate it. You don't know what you're learning. You're just kind of learning. You're just kind of soaking it all in. Just, it was so much fun. So, all right. I need to get my score. So I'm at 21 plus 21. I've gone around the thing twice. So 42. So I'm at 49 down here. I'm on round 9. So, sorry. This has been all bourbon talk. I don't know. I don't plan these things, you know. I start going somewhere and my brain keeps me going that way. And then next thing you know, it's been 20 minutes and all I've done is gabber and jabber about bourbon. Which may be what you want. Maybe I'll do that more. Who knows? I'm just kind of doing it how to have some fun with my podcast, you know? So, all right. Have I gone around twice? Cause if I have, I'm done. I don't feel like I've been shooting that well. There's no way I'm at 34 down here though. Cause if you go around the board once, right, it goes to 21. So I'm not looking at what I'm recording. So sorry. So I'm at 13. So 21 plus 13 gives you 34. But if I'm gone around twice, that puts me at 55 and I'm done. I don't know. I'll throw one more round. I don't know what's going on. So 49 plus 34 puts you at 80. Oh God, that makes me 2 rounds more. I bet that's where I'm at. So, okay. So 34 plus 49. I already forgot what that was. 84. So I need 16 points here. I just poured myself some new Riff single barrel. I try to keep it to one drink per session, per podcast. Ooh, we need 16. 2 in the middle. Let's get there. Come on. Oh, can't do it now. Oh, goodness. Yeah, this is going to be 11 rounder. Son of a gun. That was round. Yeah, I switched sides. That was round 10 even though. I said, hey, I shoot even. I messed all that up by going down there and refilling my drink. So I got 9 in the middle. 10, 11, 12, 13. So I need 3 this round. God dang. All right. Well, I don't know if I was very informative on really anything tonight, but I'll tell you what, flavor-wise, if you're enjoying Knob Creek, you enjoy Elijah Craig, this will be something you will hopefully absolutely adore. Yeah, it's just, in second glass, like, for me, that's the real measure of a bourbon. Like, if your flavor doesn't become overwhelming, if it just tastes like just losing flavor, look, game on the board, 100 points. Like, that really has an effect on me, at least. Because typically, I'm not going to have just one glass. I'll have, most of the time, if I'm not doing a video, I'll have 2 glasses a night, you know, max 3. Might be even a little lighter pour. All right, 3 on, 100 points. Took me 11 rounds. Proof is in the pudding. Nope. The proof is in the bourbon. There it is. And thanks again for JDT Caddy. Haven't mentioned their name on this podcast yet. They're awesome. That's what's holding my drink. On top and bottom, keeping score for me, because obviously I am struggling with that tonight already. But yeah, I'm telling you, obviously if you're watching this, you're probably enjoy some bourbon. Check out the new riff. New to Kansas. Here's what it looks like. I'm drinking the single barrel. They have a regular bourbon too. I believe it comes in at 100 proof. I will have to double check that. But, I mean, if $54, and we got it at $54. So, if you can't find it around town, come up to Sam's. I'll take care of you. So, anyway, I hope you enjoyed Whiskey and Washers tonight. Thanks again for watching. It was quite a bourbon evening. And the reason why is this beautiful bottle right there. So, hope you enjoyed it as always. I'm Ryan. I'll talk to you later.